Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin and welcome back to the Naio Nails channel. Today we are going to do a nail on the silicone hand. We're now going to see if you can actually put a nail on it. Who knows? Right, so first of all, I presume I do have to prep the nail. Like, because it's rubber. Because what would happen if you... Oh, you can scratch it.
Yeah, but you don't want to, though.
I think we might need to.
Yeah, but if you did that, then you're only going to be able to use it a handful of times.
I think I want to, because I think it's too shiny. I think the acrylic could just peel straight off it.
All right, okay.
Okay, I'm going to go for it. I'm just going to go over with my block.
Oh, this is so creepy.
Yeah, it doesn't feel too great.
Hey, at least there's not going to be no blood in this one at all.
Oh,
no matter
no.
What happens.
I'm not going to cut my client today.
Not that that's a thing that happens a lot.
No, I was just seeing if I could file the edge of the nail.
I'm just going to do the free edge.
Just going to do the free edge. Don't need to push back the cuticles. Those were already done when we did the mould. Only because I'm thinking we need a bit of an edge. So I'm just going to try and make it a little bit more prominent. Only ever so slightly. I don't want to like break it or anything.
Is it nice to not have somebody fighting back?
Yeah, she is a bit stiff.
Oh, right.
She's a bit stiff.
Well, that comes in handy for what its original
I suppose
use
it does.
Was.
I suppose it does. So. Okay. And dust. This is just all wrong. I'm going to wipe over with gel. In my little spray bottle, I've got gel residue wipe off solution. Just clean over. Don't need no primer or anything like that. Well, I'll tell you what, it's a good client this is. Don't need to even waste any dehydrator or primer on it. So let's just have a go at putting this foam on now. Science tells me that it won't stick very well.
Will you move your fingers?
I am gonna cut here because it's kind of this bit of skin's. It's not even skin. It's not even skin. This part of the finger is interfering with how the form is fitting. So I'm gonna do that on both sides. So it allows this part to jump out wider and this part to stay nice and narrow. Basically, it gives room for the sides of the fingers. Okay, this is just weird. It keeps doing that. Right, okay. So all I'm going to do is sculpt out a normal nail. I say normal, you know, like an almond kind of. Let me look at this. Yeah, I'll just do like an almond nail. And we'll just test it. We're just going to test it. We're going to see if it works. I want to bring you on the journey of testing the Willy hand. Because you need to be here. You need to experience this with me. I'm going to use max adhesion because I'm thinking it might adhere to it better. Maybe. We'll see. Who knows? Okay, right, okay. So we'll use... what matches that skin colour? Might use rose glow. It's a a bit pink here. Here goes. Even if this doesn't work, you know, I've had so much fun. I've had so much fun making this. And I kind of just want to make lots of things now. Not willies, but I kind of want to make, you know, I don't know what. Just things. Silicon molds of just things.
Feet.
I don't know about feet. I'm thinking, like, I would like to make a mold of a hand with nails on and see what that kind of looks like. I'd like to do a mold of like bottles and things like that, and we could do some bottles like this and do different things.
Okay, you enjoy yourself.
Oh well, that bead ain't big enough. Let's go for a bigger bead.
Is it giving you enough resistance?
Yeah.
So I suppose that's a big part of it, isn't it? Having resistance helps you to sculpt better.
I just felt like I didn't pick up quite enough product there. Just added a little bit more. I mean, she's a good client. She doesn't moan and all that. I think she's a nice lady. We are going to call the hand Dawn because it is modelled on Dawn. It is very resistant, to be honest, but I suppose that's what it's supposed to be like. Yeah, it's quite stiff. But I can move her where I want to move her. But it feels like, do you know, one of them clients that's trying to move the hand back?
Yeah.
And you just think, oh, will you just relax? And you say to them, eventually, because you've had enough, yeah, just relax, relax.
But she hasn't got any ears.
No, so, but you know, I'm coping with it, all right. I like it at the minute. I am actually liking it more than I thought I would do. I can feel it warming a little bit.
Oh, yeah, it'll take longer to cure, to...
Cure?
Yeah, cure.
Because
there's no body heat.
Mm-hmm.
I like the look of it more than I do when I see people using those practice hands that are like the plastics with the joints.
Oh, yes. It's definitely better than the nail trainer hand.
Yeah, it looks...
Definitely. However, this... It's popping off!
Oh.
No! Epic fail!
So, with those trainer hands, what is it that
it's a nail that sticks in.
Ah.
So, can we just glue it on, do you think?
Well, that's what I was going to suggest, was...
Can we just glue a nail on?
What I was going to suggest was, if that's the case, what you should probably do is glue a tip on. No, because then that would come off with the acrylic, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Like if you glued a tip on the same shape as the nail bit.
Yeah. I hope you're enjoying coming on this journey with us. So let's put some glue on the nail itself, the nail tip. Well, the acrylic. Pop it on. Think it's weird?
Mm-hmm. Quite fast setting that, isn't it?
No, it's popping at the back still. Like, these need to be more rigid. The actual fingernail needs to be harder. Let's see what happens with this now. Because it's on. So I'm going to support it as I file it. Definitely coming off. So I am really pressing down onto that nail bed now to keep it nice and secure. The thing with the nail trainer hands, they aren't a very good shape. Like the actual nails that they provide, the nail beds that they provide for you to do nails on, they're an awful shape and it makes it really difficult. Considering this product isn't made for this purpose, I'm on about the silicone. I think it's been good. Pros and cons with everything. Right, so let's give it a buff. I've just had a great idea though. If I do it like a cast of my hand, I can make nails on my hand that fit me, and I could just glue them on whenever I was going somewhere special. So you can see that it's lifting off. Let's wipe over. I'm going to wipe over it with some gel residue wipe off solution. And then...
How do you feel about your structure on it?
It's alright. The only thing I don't like is the fact that it's coming away at the back. But I can cope with that. For practicing, I can cope with it. So I'm going to put on top coat. I'm not going to touch the silicone hand when I do this. If you get any on the hand, you can easily wipe it off. And then we're going to put this in the lamp.
You best pull the lamp over already.
And we'll finish off with a little bit of cuticle oil, eh?
That's where it pops off easier. Just slides off.
Slides off. Right, so let's see if we can take it off. Maybe we need to pour a little bit of oil down the back.
Wow, you're so rough with your clients, Kirsty.
Oh, there we are. And it hasn't damaged it, has it? So if I was making this for myself, I'd just smooth this a little bit. So if it was going on and I was making it for myself, I would put crystals around the cuticle area so you could never see that join. The only other thing I find is it gathers dust a lot. Kind of like fluffy bits kind of stick to it. I think it's too playful. I just want to keep playing with it. So So, overall verdict, I think it's okay. It has its flaws and its downfalls. I think it's all right for practicing on. However, when you put that acrylic on, you do need to glue the nail back on. If I come up with another way of doing it in the meantime, we will do a video on that and show you how I've got on. But what do you think? What do you think? Do you think it's good? Do you think it's bad? Do you think it's ugly? So, yeah, guys, let us know what you think. I'm on the fence. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Everything that we use today will be listed below, as always. And I'll see you guys in the next video. What could be next? Who knows? Bye-bye.